Good evening. The current wave of COVID is breaking all records in New South Wales. More than 23,000 new cases today and hospital admissions passing the previous peak. Testing queues across Sydney were again overwhelmed as public anxiety rises over the Omicron outbreak.
It's the pressure that doesn't seem to ease. The most common sight in Sydney right now, a line of cars or a queue of people waiting hours to get a COVID test.
We went to a couple of clinics and they already closed.
Obviously it's under-resourced, but you know, everyone's overwhelmed with it all.
This enormous queue at Macquarie Park, a 2.5 hour wait. The line closed at 1 because testing stopped at 3:30, all adding to growing COVID anxiety.
Very nervous as a person who has an immune problem.
As for where that's being directed,
I think we are being abandoned by the government, left to fight the fight for ourselves.
Our COVID records were broken again today, 23,131 new cases and our highest number of COVID positive people in hospital, 1,344. There are 10 more people in intensive care, 105, and there were 2 more deaths. But just 83,000 people were tested yesterday, another drop. Not helped by testing clinics closing early or closed altogether. Australian Clinical Labs so overwhelmed it's closed 28 of its drive-through and walk-in centres to help with processing results. But the alternative, rapid antigen tests, remain almost impossible to find. This queue outside a pharmacy in Paddington, another sign of the times. The consumer watchdog says it's aware there's been price gouging by some retailers and it's put them all on notice.
They shouldn't be obviously engaging in cartel conduct. But also we're pointing out that we have the ability to name and shame people if they are doing the wrong thing.
In the midst of this growing outbreak anxiety, neither the Premier nor the Health Minister would agree to be interviewed today. The last time we saw them, New Year's Eve, although Dominic Perrottet did find time for politics, attending the Maruya races yesterday ahead of the Bega by-election.
Look, I'm not calling for a daily press conference from the Premier, but I am calling for daily management of this pandemic and the government's response to it.
And with reports health and medical staff are being pressured to come back to work, the opposition says it's a telling sign of the state of the health system.
The government criticised the opposition about 10 days ago because the opposition said that the public hospital system was under stress. They criticised us for that. They should have taken it as an early warning system.
The message again today, vaccines remain the key. And from today, millions more Australians are now eligible for booster shots after the time frame between the second and third vaccine doses was shortened from 5 months to 4 months. And in a positive sign, pharmacists in particular say they are slammed with bookings now stretching out weeks.
All the pharmacies are opening till later. For instance, I'm working till 11, 12 o'clock sometimes just to finish up paperwork. I'm asking people to come in after closing hours just so that I'm able to give them a dose of the booster.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
It's hoped Australia's Omicron wave will peak earlier than first thought, with new data out of South Africa showing a rapid decline in cases. Laura Tunstall has a breakdown of the numbers.
Officials in South Africa believe they've passed the peak of their Omicron outbreak. The latest data shows cases have dropped 30% in the last week to less than 11,500 a day. It's prompted speculation that the UK may soon be heading down a similar path. They're predicting their peak in hospital admissions to be this week or next. Daily cases there are continuing to climb, currently sitting at 162,572. Here in Australia, we've hit a record 37,151 cases today. So how far off the peak are we? I asked infectious diseases expert Professor Robert Boy.
We'll see a peak in Australia within weeks during January in different parts of Australia. Sydney will probably peak first, then Melbourne, and then other parts of Australia will follow soon after.
Hospital occupancy usually peaks a week later than case numbers, but the overseas data does give hope that this latest wave will be over in weeks as opposed to months.
And experts are monitoring a new COVID variant uncovered in France, believed to have 50 mutations. It's been identified by infectious diseases experts in Marseille, where 12 people are thought to be infected.